Hey Cafe crew, it's Colin Smith here from Photoshop Cafe, and Adobe has just released Lightroom Classic. Lightroom Classic is what used to be Lightroom 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 and Lightroom CC. Now it is renamed to Lightroom Classic, and Lightroom CC is a suite of programs including a new desktop app and other apps that all kind of sync together. So anyway, let's have a look and see what's new inside of Photoshop Lightroom Classic CC. Not a long name at all. No, not at all, not at all. And another thing worth mentioning, in Lightroom Classic, it's been sped up substantially, because I know a lot of people were complaining about the speed. They were like, you know, on forums, all this stuff. No more new features, please just fix the speed. So Adobe's done exactly that. They've jumped in there and put a lot of work into the way that the preview files and things work, and a lot of things are significantly faster. I think you're really gonna notice that. But they also dropped in another feature which is really cool. It's a new refine edge for the masking. So instead of auto mask, now we have a lot of control over there to get really precise masks. Another thing I might mention too, as far as syncing, Lightroom Classic can still sync. You can sync one library from one of your computers. You can still work with the mobile apps, and you can even share those libraries. Maybe I'll do another video later on where that's gonna work. But I do just wanna say something. If you are currently on Lightroom Classic, do not just upgrade everything to Lightroom CC right away. Maybe, you know, get Lightroom CC and play around for a few photos and then just kind of figure it out and then slowly migrate into there with the photos you want. Don't just start uploading terabytes into the cloud until you've kind of got that figured out a little bit. All right, so here we have a picture here of a bird, and he's got a little bit of an audience going on here. And what we want to do is darken down the bird but lighten up the background a little bit. So why don't we start with the background? We're just going to give it a little boost in color temperature and open up our exposure a little bit. It's looking a little better, but now the bird is getting too bright. So we want to just darken that down. We're going to grab the brush here, and we're going to start making a selection. In fact, why don't I turn on the mask so we can see it? So I'm just going to hit the O key for overlay, and I'm going to start to paint. Now, I don't want to turn on the auto mask in this case. What I want to do is just select the bird. Now notice as I'm selecting the bird, it's also selecting the background. Okay, well in this case, what we can do is I want to use the range masking, but rather than use color, I want to use luminance, and I'll show you color in a second. But if we use luminance, watch what happens here. We can play around with the range, and notice as I move that range, see how it starts to take it away from the background and just affect our bird. And of course we can play with the smoothness here if we want to get a more precise adjustment. Okay, so let's hide our mask by hitting the O key. And now if we hit the highlight recovery, notice it's just happening on the bird. Maybe bring the exposure down a little bit. And maybe give it just a little pop of saturation. And if we look at this before and after, you can see now it's bringing it down in the bird. Now, if you want to adjust everything overall, we just click here and maybe just give it a little punch of contrast. And there we go. We've got before and after. Okay, let's look at some other examples. Let's go in here. And what I want to do is I want to lighten up this building here and not the background. You know, we've got the star trail here. So what we're going to do now is we're going to make the radial tool, and I'm just going to make a selection around there. Okay, so what we want to do here is we want to select just the color in there. So what we're going to do is we're going to give it just a little punch of exposure, and notice right now it's affecting everything. And of course we want to invert and go in here. So we don't want to affect the sky, just this area. Okay, so we're going to choose the range mask, and we're going to choose color, grab this eyedropper, and now let's click and drag in here to select that color, and now we can play around with the amount and notice how we can just affect the building or go like that. So now we're just going to maybe just get it in a little bit so it looks a little bit more natural, and maybe want to boost our saturation and maybe recover our highlights a little bit, open up the shadows a bit, and maybe give this a punch of clarity. All right, so if we look at this now, and we go before and after, you can see what we're doing there is we're just affecting that building as if we just kind of illuminated it. Okay, let's look at another example. Okay, so here's a photograph that I shot during a supermoon at night. So there was a lot of light there and I was able to shoot with a very slow exposure. I made some initial adjustments, but now I want to darken the sky down a little bit without darkening the tree too much. So what we're going to do is grab our gradient tool and then we're just going to click and drag down. In fact, let me drag it all the way down to here. And now here's what happens. If I drop the exposure down to get the sky looking good, notice that the tree is also being affected. So if I go to range mask and I choose color, grab the eyedropper, and now we select the blue, make a box around there. Notice now that the tree is not lightened. So if we play around with the exposure, notice it's only really affecting that background. Now you can play around with it as well just by tweaking it with this amount slider, and you can just get it exactly how you want it. So maybe we want to hit the highlights a little bit more, and I'm going to give this a push of clarity. There we go. And we can see, you know, if we look at this before and after, here's our before, and here's our after. So you can see how cool these tools are. So thanks for watching, guys. I hope you liked this. If you did, smash that like button into dust. If you like these kind of tutorials and you want more, make sure you hit the subscribe button to become part of the Cafe crew. If you have subscribed, hit the notification and you'll never miss another one of my tutorials. So anyway, add a comment. I love to read the comments. Let's get a discussion going, positive, negative, requests, whatever it is, just drop it into the comments right now and I'll read them and we can share them. And until next time, I'll see you at the Cafe.